4 o'clock. Hey, so, yeah, does that work?
Yeah, absolutely. It's very important work. You saw how much people liked it the last time we did something like this, right? I mean, you could even say this is God's work.
I could say this is God's work. What does that mean?
Well, it's Temple OS. It's God's third temple.
God's third temple. Lord. Okay, we're gonna get demonetized over all the religious stuff going on here. Fortunately, today's video is sponsored by Elgato. Elgato's new Wave 1 and Wave 3 USB broadcast microphones are here. With their Wavelink app, you can control your Wave mic, up to 7 other audio sources, and create independent mixes. Learn more at the link down below. Tell me about what I'm looking at here, please.
Okay, Temple OS is an open source operating system developed by Terry Davis, a longtime computer enthusiast who cut his teeth on the old Commodore 64 back in the 80s. He began the project back in 2003, then called J Operating System, in order to go back to those roots. In his own words, to recreate the dynamic environment that used to exist when the Commodore 64 was around, and everyone was creating oddball software. And you can clearly see that inspiration in the interface he ended up with.
Unfortunately, Terry's mental state had been deteriorating rapidly since being diagnosed with schizophrenia in the mid to late 90s, and he began to see what he believed were CIA agents shadowing him. The story is long, complex, dramatic, and unfortunately, ultimately, very tragic. But to sum it up, he began to see what he interpreted as signs from God resulting in direct communication through an oracle in the form of a pseudo-random number generator function that he programmed into the operating system.
Now, while his vocabulary became increasingly, well, let's just call it controversial, in an attempt to combat the psychological warfare he believed was being conducted against him, it was through these conversations that he got the inspiration for many of the foundational elements of Temple OS, which he says God told him was the biblical third temple. 640 by 480 pixels, with 16 colors, VGA graphics, single voice audio through the PC speaker, with no preemptive multitasking, and a completely open Ring Zero design that gives users complete control over their hardware. In other words, it's a tinkerer's dream come true, so long as you know how to use it.
Well, I don't know how to use it, but I'm assuming that it's set up here so that you can guide me through taking it for a spin.
Sure, let's do it.
Let's do it. This is interesting. I don't think I've seen an interface this unintuitive and cluttered. There's so many flashing items that it's not clear to me what is selected or not selected. Anthony, help me out here.
Okay, so right now you have a mouse.
Oh, I do.
You can use that.
Oh, look at that, I got a mouse.
Now, how familiar are you with the C programming language?
Yeah, let's go Eli 5 here.
Okay, so everything in this operating system, including the operating system itself, is programmed in what's called Holy C.
Holy C.
Yeah.
You have got to be kidding me.
He was a
Catholic.
He
made his own language.
Yeah, he was a Catholic. And he named the language Holy C. It's somewhere in between a C and a C++ level of power and versatility. And basically, in that vein, the entire operating system runs on those commands. So it's all that. That's what you're looking at right now. This is what's called the home menu.
The home menu.
You can get there at any time by pressing Control and M.
Control M, okay, got it. And that's the menu flashing up here. Why do I have a menu flashing on the left and the right?
Because you currently have two windows open. You can close one of those if you'd like. There you go. You cannot close that background window, that's Atom. It's the debugger and program monitor.
Right, got it, makes perfect sense, okay.
Yeah.
System keys quick guide, space is left click and enter is right click. F7 is God word.
Yes.
What happened? Turn.
It just put a word up there.
Textaltation?
Yeah, that's what you...
Oh, exaltation. Wait, yeah. What is this?
That's the window.
That's the
title.
Window.
Yeah, so what you're looking at right there, this, the blinking black square is your text cursor. You can control that with the arrow
keys.
Wait,
so if I press F7, it'll just... Abides. Retired. Hereditary. Circuit. Mouths. Names. Are these just words that occur in the Bible?
I think it's every word that the operating system is like actually aware of.
Husbands. Philip. What about Shift F7? Whoa, hey, ho, told him said as I happened by chance, leaning upon his spear, and lo, the something hard after him. And when I looked behind him, he said, I answered, here am I. And he said to me, who art thou? Amalekite. Wow, so that's a god passage. F6 is a god song.
Now that we won't be able to hear right now. We can come back to that later.
Oh, because we're in
VM. Yeah.
Okay. OS navigation is handled through a combination of mouse inputs and shortcut keys, some of which work throughout the entire operating system, regardless of what you are looking at. Some of them are things that you would need in any operating system, like a shortcut to go to the personal menu or to exit, for example. Others are ones that are unique to this one, like the shortcuts to bring up a god song, god doodle passage or word. I think the words are from the Bible. They might also just be from the dictionary that this OS has access to, as well as a system-wide Bible that you can get to simply by pressing, what was it, Control-Shift-B?
Control-Alt-B.
Control-Alt-B. There it is.
And there it is.
One piece of the operating system that certainly underlines the struggle of its creator is the Holy Spirit menu, which you can access after you open up the God Doodle application. Here you'll find some sort of general statements interpreting the Bible and the world, as well as a Q&A with the random number generator that we alluded to before. The answers in the Q&A range from things that kind of make sense, like the 14th commandment is apparently no pedophilia or child porn. Yeah, I can get behind that. Two things that seemingly have nothing to do with the question being asked and everything in between. Like, this is a great answer. Does he like mirrored glass megachurch? Secular glass. Yeah, sounds about right. Wait, what are we doing right now?
This is a god doodle.
How do I know when it's done?
Yeah, it'll be done eventually. So one of the things about this, you might notice that there are animated icons,
yeah,
as well as, you know, just general icons on this menu, despite the fact that it is text mode.
Yeah.
He created a special file format that allows him to insert those things along with songs and other stuff into what is essentially just an ASCII file.
Huh.
And what you're looking at right now is basically a straight text file, except it has these things built in.
That's kind of cool. Are these all, wait, hold on a second. Fun games, unfun games, code scraps, and non-games.
So the tour is actually right there, above fun games.
Yeah.
That tells you all you need to know about actually navigating and using the system.
Wow. The type command is like the DOS command of the same name or the Unix command. It will now send your menu document to the command line. It uses the same document format and the icons are even active. Wow. So that's the end of the tour, I guess. Oh,
that would be, yeah.
Oh, my menu's over on the right now.
You can actually move and resize windows as you please if you click on the borders, except for Atom. You can't change Atom. But if you were to click and drag.
Okay, what else can we do?
Well, I mean, there are games we can play.
Can we start with an unfun one and see how it goes?
Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna go with Zone Out. I refuse to rip off the original, so this is intentionally crappy and included for demonstration purposes. Write games, don't play them.
So this is a Battlezone clone. One thing you'll notice is that the keystrokes appear to be BIOS keystrokes. So you'll hit a button and it'll turn once and then it'll wait for the repeat and then it'll keep turning. And it can only do one of them at a time.
Look at me. I'm sniping him. Oh, shoot.
Well, that one didn't even hit.
Yeah, the hitbox detection is the least of its problems. Yeah, that was unfun. All right, why don't we try a fun game like Wenceslas? Start fires by pressing space. Nice, on trees. They're Yule logs. Lead peasants to fires. Okay, so we start fires. Did I start a fire or not? Oh, I started a fire, okay. So how do I bring the peasant to the fire?
They'll follow your footsteps.
So I have to like...
You have to really babysit them.
So did I get a point?
Yeah, so freezing peasants I think went from 10 to 9.
So are these peasants on fire now?
I'm not sure if they're on fire. You're not Trogdor, but...
Burninating all the peasants.
We gotta stop making that reference. It's too old.
It is too old. People don't get it.
Some people do.
And for those three people, it's the best reference. Okay, I think I've had enough of this. But hey, solid 30 FPS, so 10 out of 10 better than Last of Us 2.
Ooh.
The troll.
All right, let's try Varum. This is the one you were playing, right?
Yes, it is.
I can see why you... I died.
Yep.
That was quick. Wow, the car goes so fast.
That was the first thing that happened to me, too. I went forward and I died.
Okay, wow, that's what happens when you go too fast. This is a learning game.
Yeah, it's this is all edutainment.
Oh, vroom, vroom, vroom. This is by far the best game so far.
Yeah, it's actually pretty decent. There's also a flight simulator kind of game.
It makes you wonder, like, just how talented this guy was before, well, you know.
Things happened.
It's like, if nothing else, this demonstrates quite a breadth of skill.
Yeah, he created all the 2D libraries and 3D libraries from scratch, the operating system from scratch, all of this from scratch. And by the way, that was 16 colors. Okay, so the final thing that I want to show you is a game called After Egypt. It is not actually included in the main distribution anymore, if it ever was. But I do have it on a CD image.
Okay.
So I'm going to show you how to, or tell you how to mount a CD image.
Wow, it has CD support. Sure, of course it does. Okay, yeah.
So go to the terminal. Okay, type, remember this has to be like capitalized, mount, semicolon, enter. Now, it supports RAM drives, hard drives, etc. What we want is a CD drive because we actually have a virtual CD set up. So type T and press P to probe. There we go. So we got the hard drive and we got the CD drive. We want to choose the CD drive. Just hit 2 and enter. And hit enter to exit. So you can see that the drive T has been loaded. Type DRV, open parentheses, quote, T, quote, close, semicolon. Okay?
Okay.
So you see that it changed the window border to blue because that is the color code of this drive.
Okay.
So just do a DIR. Now, choose supplemental games.
So CD, I can just click it. Oh, awesome.
After Egypt. Now, type hashtag.
Hashtag.
It's a pound sign. Include, space, quote, run, with capital R, quote, and just enter. And type a colon and hit enter. So this is something that Terry was very proud of back when he created it. This is a Moses simulator?
Yeah, like I'm on Mount Sinai, kind of looking down at the... Okay, so we've got a golden calf, that's bad.
Yeah, so you can hit escape. That'll bring up a menu.
Oh, so it's like an Oregon Trail style, like choice-making adventure game, sort of.
He didn't ever actually create like an end goal or anything like that. This is more of like a software toy, like a de-stressing thing.
So wait, so when there's a golden calf, I should probably, okay. Wait, Mount Horeb? I thought it was Mount Sinai.
I'm actually not sure.
What mountain did Moses climb?
Mount Sinai.
Yeah.
According to the Denver Post, Catherine, Egypt.
Okay, so I need to find a burning bush.
Yeah, so you'll use the arrow keys for this. Okay, so now you're at the Oracle. We get to see what God says. Sometimes it's a Bible passage. Sometimes it's something different. Okay, you got the good thing. This is the difference. This is God speaking directly to you.
Grievous shakes discord decided allay whatsoever, potter biting, mark observed, province ye, whilst likewise scourges by. I feel like trying to find meaning in it might lead me farther from knowledge.
I mean, it did have the word potter in there.
So I should fire Colton.
There's only one person here named Potter.
Sorry, Colton, Temple OS told me to do it. So why is this not included in the core game anymore?
I'm not sure. It might have been that he never actually included it. It was something he was working on, or it might have been, I don't actually know what the history of After Egypt is. I do know that he was very proud of it when he created it, though.
Got it.
It's not strictly, I think it's not strictly a demo, so he didn't include it.
Can it do anything else useful?
Well, yeah. If I were better at programming and had more time, I could probably whip something up. It's, from what I understand, very easy to draw shapes, very easy to create sprites, that kind of thing. So it's really a tinkerer's tool, like a beginner's programming operating system. Like, you have full control over the hardware here.
So that's a really cool idea.
Yeah, it's like an old school Commodore 64. So the God Song.
Right, that. Yeah, we couldn't do that because we didn't have sound.
Right, so this one does have sound, it just crashed in the games. So let's try that.
Okay, so F6.
F6. So you can choose what kind of level of complexity you want, whether it has rests.
Sure, let's have rests.
What octave it has. I'm not sure what 6/8 means. So simple, normal, complex.
I want a complex song.
Complex?
I'm a complex kind of guy. Hilariously, I don't think it's worse than like the soundtrack of like a Hugo's House of Horrors or something like that.
Yeah, that's actually not terrible.
Like there's some garbage.
There's some garbage parts in it, yeah. But yeah.
What a thing. If you guys want to learn more, check out Frederick Knudsen's Down the Rabbit Hole investigation into the creation of Temple OS and its creator. It's far more in-depth than what we could possibly cover here, but I have to say it was quite the experience. You guys can try it out for yourselves, by the way. We'll have a link to where to get it down in the video description. You can fire it up in a VM. That's probably the easiest way to get it working. And yeah, go ham. And the video is brought to you by Manscaped. Manscaped created the world's first all-in-one manscaping kit that makes manscaping both safe and easy. The Perfect Package 3.0 includes everything you need to take your grooming routine to the next level, including their Lawnmower 3.0 waterproof body trimmer with its ergonomic design, quality ceramic blades, and advanced skin-safe technology. I mean, you don't want to nick your balls, right? Nobody wants to nick their balls. Those of you who want to nick your balls, feel free to let me know in the comments. I will make sure I get you guys all blocked away because I don't need to hear from y'all. The replaceable ceramic trimmer blade is 100% compatible with both the Lawnmower 2.0 and 3.0 with its powerful 7,000 RPM motor and 600 milliamp hour lithium ion battery. It charges wirelessly, it's waterproof, and you can get 20% off and free shipping with your Perfect Package 3.0 purchase when you use code LTT at the link below or on manscaped.com. Thanks for watching this video. If you guys enjoyed it, maybe check out our previous alternative operating systems episode on React OS. A little more conventional, but frankly, not much more useful. Depending on what you're trying to do, at least this is a Bible reading app.
Well, it's that, and it's also like a modern day Commodore 64. You can tinker with it. That's the point.
Yeah.